Once you understand the basics of what a query is, you will be able to move on to actually creating queries using simple criteria. And criteria just means that you are adding some conditions that the data that you pull has to satisfy. And you can see that if you are just adding one condition, then you can just use the verbiage criterion instead of criteria. But to enter a criterion for a field, then you will have to make sure that you include that field in the design grid, and then also make sure that you enter whatever criteria you have in the criteria row for that field. And when you create queries using simple criteria, a lot of the time you will use some sort of comparison operator, such as equal to, greater than, less than, and so on. And those are listed for you in the presentation that accompanies Chapter 2, as well as in your book around page 36. So looking at the Tau Distributors database, let's look at how we would do a simple little query and add some criteria to it. The first thing that I will need to do is click Create and open up the query design view. And in this example, I'm just going to add the customer table. And remember that any fields that we would like to show on our query need to be added down here to our design grid. And I'm going to look for any customers who are represented by the number 126. So if that is my query, then I probably want to add both customer number and customer name to my design grid. And since I only want to see customers that have a number of 126, that is my criteria for this query, which I need to enter here. And since I'm looking for something specific, all I have to do is add it here just as that number 126. And when I run that query, you can see that only customers whose number is actually 126 are going to be shown, and in this case it is Toys Galore. Now, since we were looking for exactly 126, we could have in design view used the equal sign here, which is a good practice to get into, especially if we were writing this in SQL instead of doing it from design view, and it would run the same way, but you can see that it would work with or without that equal sign here. And of course, we could also search for other specifics using those operators such as less than, greater than, and so on. So that's an example of just a simple query using simple criteria, but sometimes we might have compound criteria or conditions, and this is when we have more than one condition that needs to be met. And in those cases, we can use AND, which of course would mean that both criteria need to be true, or we could use OR, which would mean that either of them must be true. And to create an AND criteria in QBE, then you'll place the criteria for multiple fields on the same criteria row. And if we want to create an OR criteria, then we would place the criteria for multiple fields on different rows in our design grid. So let's take a look at how that would look in an actual example. So for example, if you would like to list the item number, description, and number of units on hand in storehouse for all the items that have more than 10 units on hand and that are located in storehouse 3, we can break that down into parts. First of all, deciding what table we're pulling from. And since we are listing so many things that are listed in that item table, when I create this query, I am going to add the item table. And the fields that I want to list are item number, description, number of units on hand, and storehouse. And the criteria that I'm looking for in this case are for those that have more than 10 units on hand and that are located in storehouse 3, which means that I'm gonna place those criteria in the same row. So I need the on hand to be more than, which is greater than 10. And I need the storehouse to be number 3. So I can just enter the 3 for storehouse. And when I run the query, you can see that only items that have 10 or more on hand are listed, and they are all in storehouse 3. Just to show you another example, if I wanted to use an or criteria, then I could do it the same way, but instead of placing the criteria on the same row, I'm going to place them on different rows. So for this example, let's say that I want to list the item number, description, and number of units on hand and the storehouse for all items that have more than 10 units on hand or are located in storehouse 3. I'm still going to use the item table. I still need to show the item number, description, on hand, and storehouse. I still would like for them to have either greater than 10 or be in storehouse 3. And since we're using or, we're going to place those in different rows. And now when I run it, you can see I get a larger list because they can meet either the criteria of having more than 10 or the criteria of being stored in storehouse 3.